Drinking, as we know, does many things to the brain.
Sorry, don't drink it every time, just do it on the final shot.
No, it's for science. Action. But drinking isn't the whole story. How else is alcohol affecting my brain? I'm Shannon, and I'm a neuroscience PhD candidate, and this is your brain.
Shannon.
You gotta take it a tank again, I think. I'm hangover. Oh, I don't think I can do this. The medical term for a hangover and its symptoms is vasalgia, a Greek and Norwegian word literally meaning uneasiness following debauchery and pain. Its typical symptoms include fatigue, headache, nausea, dizziness, thirst, sound and light sensitivity, diarrhea, and a deep fear to check your phone to see what messages you sent last night.
Who are you texting?
I'm texting my mom. I'm gonna do a brunch at my place.
I'm shooting tomorrow.
So I took the day off. I just invited my landlord.
It generally starts when your blood alcohol level drops to zero and can last upwards of 24 hours. If you get legally intoxicated, reaching a blood alcohol level of 0.08, it would take about 6 hours for your hangover symptoms to kick in and start kicking your ass.
A common theory is that the nausea and mental symptoms accompanying your hangover may be due to the buildup of acetaldehyde in the body. Acetaldehyde is the initial product of alcohol metabolism, created as alcohol is broken down in the liver. One reason why acetaldehyde is thought to be the culprit is that, for one thing, it is a toxic compound. Also, one study showed that people with the genetic deficiency in the ALDH2 gene, aka the gene which codes for the enzyme that breaks down and rids the body of that acetaldehyde, well, those individuals show much worse hangover symptoms.
Do you get pretty bad hangovers?
I never.
Why?
This is your idea.
Okay, sure, great answer.
The theory that acetaldehyde is causing hangovers is often debated, because by the time you wake up, though you are full of regret, acetaldehyde is no longer detectable in the body. If my thirst is telling me anything, drinking alcohol definitely makes you dehydrated. So, could this dehydration be the reason for my hangover? Alcohol acts on the hypothalamus, located at the base of your brain, blocking the production of the hormone vasopressin. Vasopressin is responsible for maintaining the osmolality of serum and extracellular fluid, aka tells your body how much water should be reabsorbed into the kidneys or if it should be sent to the bladder. By blocking this hormone, your body sends all this extra water to the bladder, causing you to run to the bathroom every other drink.
Gotta stay hydrated. Gotta stay hydrated.
One and one.
You're gonna be
equals out to zero drinks.
Therefore, alcohol has a diuretic effect, leaving your body eager to replace the water it lost.
Oh no, I spilled on myself. I'm sorry. I ruined it. I spilt.
So, is it dehydration? While dehydration can cause altered potassium and sodium levels, leading to headaches and pain, rehydration cannot completely alleviate hangover symptoms, suggesting that there must be more going on. But just to be safe, I'll try not to move it. I didn't spill it. Catch that? As my college roommate used to tell me, the best hangover cure is a huge, greasy morning meal. Is there any science to that? Well, alcohol does interfere with the liver and its ability to generate glucose, causing a decrease in blood sugar the next morning. If you've ever dealt with a hangry friend, you know that low blood sugar is linked to tiredness, crankiness, and dizziness. So, could a short stack of pancakes really be the answer? Once again, scientists find that elevating blood sugars back to normal alone does not get rid of the hangover, suggesting that low blood sugar is not the hangover culprit. But we might as well try, right? This looks disgusting. Mm.
One of the most convincing theories of what could be the reason behind your hangover has to do with the immune system. One study in humans found that cytokine levels were increased during a hangover. Cytokines are the signaling molecules of the immune system. You can think of them as the news reporters of the body, gathering, increasing, and sending out signals when there's any type of stress around the body. Normally, these cytokines are increased when the body is fighting off an infection, suggesting that drinking alcohol may cause your body to have a similar response that it would when you're getting the flu. This immune response, though peripheral, can in fact affect the brain through the vagus nerve. The vagus nerve is sort of like the telephone line between the brain and the immune system. It's like a landline.
Is this gonna be clearer tomorrow?
Clear right now. It's like a phone line. Speak.
Can I have my phone back?
Through communication through this telephone line, the immune system tells the brain we are sick, causing an increase in the brain's own immune response, which may lead to sickness behavior, which can include the inability to concentrate, our increased tiredness, our loss of interest, and feelings of weakness. I can't.
Oh no, I broke my house.
So is there a reason that my hangover feels worse today than it did last weekend? Actually, yes. Scientists have attributed worse hangovers to drinking alcoholic substances that are high in congeners. Congeners are substances that are not ethanol, which are also produced in the fermentation process. These congeners are diverse, and they include methanol, acetone, esters, tannins, and aldehydes. Dark alcohols such as bourbon and wine are high in congeners, while clear liquors such as vodka and gin are low in congeners. Ugh, I wish I knew that before I was ordering all those rum and cokes.
I would like a rum and coke.
You have a scotch right now.
I would like a rum and coke, please. So while there are a lot of quick fix hangover products on the market, until scientists figure out the complete neurobiological reason for the hangover, it's unlikely we'll have a miracle drink or pill that works. Based on my investigation, the best way to avoid a hangover? Don't drink so damn much. Stop hanging out with Karen. You know that girl's gonna make you drink 2 tequila shots too many. Can't get away from Karen? Well, it seems that the only real cure is time. And on that note, I'm gonna take some time. So get out, lock the door behind you, okay?
I need to sleep.